So we want to determine the electric field produced by two charges. One of which is positive, one of which is negative. So we have two sources now. So this is like that sample C when we looked at the field lines. So the positive source is stronger than the negative source. And we want to figure out what the field is halfway between them. So go ahead and draw a positive source here and a negative source here. From the positive source, the field line should be drawn away. And the negative source, field line should be drawn toward. Remembering that things end on the negative and start on the positive. So, take a look at this. If you wanted to find the force or the field strength halfway between it, you're looking at some point in space right here. Put a little X in the middle. You're looking at some point in space. Well, the positive source wants to have field lines drawn away. The negative source wants to have field lines drawn toward it. So as a result, these lines kind of continue like we saw. That's what we saw on the last example when we drew the field lines in. Away from positive and toward a negative clearly means that we're going to be moving everything from the positive to the negative. So as a result, you should jot this down. You should jot this down. As a result, if you ever have two opposite sources, the field strength anywhere between them is the sum. It's just an X right here to show a spot, a location. If you have two opposite sources, meaning one positive, one negative, the field strength at an arbitrary location between them doesn't have to be halfway. That's why I'm saying arbitrary. Again, if you have two sources of opposite signs or opposite sources, the field strength at an arbitrary location between them is the sum.
What?
The sum of the field strengths from each.
The field sum.
Say again, Mark.
The field sum.
It's equal to the sum of the field strengths produced by each source. So you're going to have to do this how many times?
Twice.
Yeah, that's all that has to happen. Now, it happens to be halfway between. If it wasn't, you would just have to use R for this one, whatever the distance is, and R for this one, whatever the distance is. We'll do that at the end. We'll show that at the end. But right now, we know that they're separated by a distance of 40 centimeters, so this is 20 centimeters, and this is 20 centimeters. So the R value for each of these will be 0.2 meters. Remember, we're not including the radius for these. We talked about that already. This Q is 3 times 10 to the negative 8 coulombs, and this is negative 2 times 10 to the negative 8 coulombs. So we've got the electric field produced by the first one. Well, we're going to write our formula every time. Let's do the one on the left and then the one on the right. KC, Q1, again, 1 is just the first source this time, okay? Over R1 squared. And the second one, the same thing, but with 2 instead. Second source over the second distance squared. And those distances happen to be the same. They're both R. They're both 20, or 0.2. Yeah, because it was in parentheses. It might be an arbitrary location in a diagram, and the diagram might say 10 and 50. Yeah. So then for this one you use 10 or 0.1, this one use 50 or 0.5. Okay, it depends on the problem that's being asked. So continuing to write in here, 9 times 10 to the 9, 3 times 10 to the negative 8, 9 times 10 to the 9, negative 2 times 10 to the negative 8. The first one is 6750.
Yeah.
Come up with E2. I want to see something. The example of the homework is that this light is good. Let's go through the videos. So we want to take a look at the last, what's the next number, was it?
-45.
Okay. So we want to look at this for a second and think to ourselves, first of all, what does that negative sign indicate?
Attraction.
Yeah, be careful. Look at this arrangement. It is, but what does the negative mean is the question, guys. The source on the right was negative, right? This was negative? So the field line means that positive charges are going to want to move toward it.
Yeah.
Everything's going to want to move this way. The sign on this was positive, which means everything wants to move away from it. So together, they're both pulling it which way? Like this one wants to move, if there's a random charge right here in the middle, and this is positive, and this is a random positive charge, it wants to push it to the right. Well, if this is again a positive charge, this wants to pull it to the right. So both of these are acting toward the right in this case. Okay, they're both acting toward the right. So when we add these together, we have to consider the fact that really what we're doing is we're looking at the absolute values and we're looking at our directionals again. So the total electric field is equal to the sum of these two if we're looking at our diagram, from our specific diagram in this case. Because both of these electric fields want a particle that's in the middle to move to the right. Both, like the negative one is pulling it, and the positive one is pushing it, but both of them are still moving it toward the right. So what do we get as an answer, simply? Okay, and think about it logically. If there's a positive source pushing something this way, there also has to be a negative source pulling it this way. They're both moving it this way. So you're summing these values together because they're both to the right. Had it been reversed, had it been a negative source here, negative source here, and a positive source here. The positive source would want to push it this way. The negative source would want to pull it this way. So they'd both be to the left. And both of these signs, you would use negative signs for. Okay, so it would be negative absolute value plus negative absolute value. So it depends on the scenario. Again, had we switched this, let me draw what I'm saying. I'm going to draw it on the bottom here. Hypothetically, had, instead of this being the way it was, had the negative sign been, which way were we on this sign? The positive was on the left. So had the negative been on the left, and the positive on the right, it would have looked like this, right? Draw yourself some field lines. And this would have looked like this now. So as a result, the field lines for a point in between here would have made it move to the left, right? These continue to the left. So had I switched my diagram, what would I have noticed? I would have just gotten a negative sign in this circumstance. It would have been negative 11, 250, because this would have been a negative up here, and this would have been a negative up here, because they would both have been moving this object toward the left. Jack?
So they always go from the positive one to the negative one?
Yes.
So depending on where the placement is, you can tell left.
Exactly. Right. This problem, I don't think I even gave you placement. I just said that it was at the midpoint, yeah. So nothing said that it was on the left or right. So to base on your diagram, you can indicate what's happening. But it says a positive test source located at the origin and a negative test source located at 10 centimeters. Well, now you know here's a negative, here's a positive. Flow is going to go this way. Okay? You know that because of the arrangement. Depending on the arrangement, though, your answer changes. Any questions on this? So, similar in math to the last section, but we don't have a Q in the formula. R is the distance from the source now, and we also recognize here that our units are newtons per coulomb and not newtons. So on the test, when you hear the electric field strength is 37,000 newtons per coulomb, that's capital E. If you heard the electric force exerted on a particle is 37 newtons, that's FE from the last section. So your units are extremely important. When you're studying, make sure you understand the units of every variable involved in each equation so you know which equation you are using in that circumstance. All right?
This homework is
hard. Yeah. Regular homework, guys. Okay?